and we have a channel and we have a receiver. Okay, then the transmitter, we do something called modulation, right? So in the receiver we do reverse of that, that is called demodulation. Correct. Now here, so to transmit a signal from one place to other place, we need a help of what? Carrier. So typically carrier is a sinusoidal signal, so which is denoted with C of t, that is AC cos omega C t. As you know, this is the amplitude of the carrier, this is the FC, we call FC is the frequency of the carrier. Okay, this is amplitude, this is frequency of the carrier. Correct. Now so if you draw this carrier, which is a sinus cos wave, a sinusoidal signal, so it has some parameters, correct? Some parameters. It has got amplitude, this is carrier. It has got amplitude and it has got what? Frequency, and it has got some phase. Here phase is zero. Okay, we are starting with zero phase. Anyway, any typical sinusoidal signal will have these parameters. Okay, what we do here is, for transmission purpose, we keep our message in the amplitude of the carrier and we transmit. Okay, so if you do so, it is called amplitude modulation. Sometimes we keep our message in the frequency of the carrier, so it is called frequency modulation. Sometimes we keep our message signal in the phase of the carrier, it is called phase modulation, PM. These are the acronyms for amplitude modulation, AM, frequency modulation, FM, phase modulation, PM. Now we'll study one by one. Okay, so first we study amplitude modulation. What is that? Amplitude modulation. So let us see what we do here. As I told you just now, so any communication system involves a carrier signal, that is C of t, okay, which is denoted with AC cos 2 pi FC t, and AC is the amplitude and FC is the frequency of the carrier. Okay, and so we have a message signal which is need to be transmitted, that we denote with M of t. What is M of t? A message signal that we are going to transmit. So the notation is very simple. So M of t means our message signal, C of t means our carrier signal. So using this carrier, we are transmitting this message signal from one place to other place. Okay, by what process? By process called modulation. Modulation is a process which transmits a message signal by using carrier to the other place. Okay, so there are so many types of this modulation, we'll discuss one by one. Correct. So next, yeah, so we are studying amplitude modulation. Okay, that is very very important. What we're studying, we're studying amplitude modulation, AM. Okay, here message modulates the amplitude of the carrier. So the definition of AM means our message signal is modulating amplitude of the carrier. Okay, now so let us take M of t is a message signal, okay, and C of t is a carrier, which is typically AC cos 2 pi FC t. Correct. Now so in AM, just now I told you, we keep our message in the amplitude of the carrier and we transmit. Okay, how to do it? Correct. Now here, so what is the amplitude of this carrier C of t? That is a constant, no? Amplitude of C of t is what? AC, which is a constant. Okay, so that is a before modulation. Okay, so this is before modulation. बिफोर मॉड्यूलेशन। Now, so what is AC? What is AM? Amplitude modulation. Message signal modulates the amplitude of the carrier. Now we have to change the amplitude of the carrier so that it contains message signal. Here amplitude is simply constant. Okay. Now after modulation, what happens? So we write this as S of T. S of T is a modulated signal. After modulation, what happens? So it is AC into 1 plus KA into M of T into cos omega CT. This is called AM signal, amplitude modulated signal. Okay. Now, so this is after modulation. This is after modulation. So if you observe carefully, it is also a cos function only, cos waveform only. So before modulation, it was simply C of T carrier, whose amplitude is AC, a constant. But after modulation, what is the amplitude of this signal? What is that? What is that? AC into 1 plus KA into M of T. Isn't it? So this is the amplitude of the carrier after modulation. Okay. Now amplitude is not a constant now. It is a function of time. I mean the time varying function. Okay. Here this is something called KA. It is called amplitude sensitivity. Now you must know this AM equation. This is very very important. Okay, so S of T is 1 plus KM of T cos 2 pi of CT AC into this is, so this is the final AM equation. Okay, where KA is called amplitude sensitivity of AM signal. S of T is called modulated signal or modulated carrier because the carrier is modulated. Okay. Now here S of T is called amplitude modulated signal or carrier or modulated carrier. What about this C of T? It is called carrier or it is also sometimes called as unmodulated carrier. What it's called as unmodulated carrier. It is before modulation. C of T is a carrier before modulation. S of T is a carrier after modulation. So there is a difference is clearly visible to you. Okay. So here the amplitude of the carrier contains message signal. Okay. So which means the carrier amplitude is carrying the message signal. Okay. So what is the purpose of this KA? All the things we'll discuss. Okay. Yeah. So let us expand this. So if you expand this, what do you get? AC into 1 plus KM of T cos 2 pi of CT. AC cos 2 pi of CT plus AC M of T cos 2 pi of CT. Now if you do it so, what is AC cos 2 pi of CT? That is nothing but C of T, isn't it? AC cos 2 pi of CT is nothing but C of T. What is C of T? Carrier or unmodulated carrier or carrier before modulation. So KA, M of T, what is this again? That is again C of T. Okay. Now this is S of T finally. Now, so S of T is, you can also write this as C of T plus KA, M of T into C of T. Okay. Now, so this is very very important. Please remember this. We have derived from the basic formula of AM only. Okay, nothing more than that. Now, So here, amplitude of the carrier signal is varied or modulated according to the amplitude of the message signal. This is the basic definition of AM. What is happening here? The amplitude of the carrier signal is varied here. So what is happening here? This is the amplitude of the carrier signal. It is no more a constant because it is a function of time now, isn't it? Now how it is varied? It is varied according to the amplitude of the message signal here. So in amplitude modulation in AM, what happens? Amplitude of the carrier is varied according to what? Please remember, according to amplitude of the message signal. This is very, very important. Message signal M of T. Here, don't say simply it is varying according to message signal. It is varying according to amplitude of the message signal. Okay, so the amplitude of the carrier is changing according to amplitude of the message signal. That is called amplitude modulation. Okay, now so that is the definition of amplitude modulation. Now, as I just now told you, so before modulation, the amplitude of the carrier was constant, simply it was AC. But after modulation, it was AC into 1 plus KA into M of T, which is a time varied function and varies according to the amplitude of the signal M of T. Okay, so these are the two things you must remember. So before modulation, what is amplitude? And after modulation, what is the amplitude? Okay, here we are not changing the frequency and phase of the carrier. As I told you, the carrier has got three parameters: amplitude, frequency, phase. Now we are changing the amplitude of the carrier, keeping frequency phase as it is. We are not doing anything with the frequency phase of the carrier. So just changing the amplitude of the carrier according to amplitude of the message signal. Okay, that is a basic definition of amplitude modulation. Okay, now next. Now, single tone amplitude modulation. Single tone, so means generally tone means a frequency. Tone, it's something like a frequency. Single tone means a signal having a one frequency component. Okay, what is that example of single tone signal? What example of single tone signal? Tell me a signal which is having only one frequency. Anyone? Tell me a signal which is having only one frequency component. You can message me at least. What are the example of single tone signals? Yeah, so it is not voice. As I told you in the last yesterday class, voice is having a frequency range from 300 to 3.3 kilohertz. How can it be single tone signal? Okay, yeah, sine or cos are single tone signals. Why? Because just now I have written, suppose if I say sine 100 pi t, what the frequency of the signal? What the frequency of the signal? How much? 50 hertz. Only one frequency, that's it. Okay, now so here single tone AM means we take M of T, message signal, as AM cos 2 pi FMT. If message signal happen to be a cos function, then it is called single tone AM. Why? Because what is AM? It is called एम इज कॉल्ड मैसेज एम्पलीट्यूड. व्हाट इज एफ एम इज कॉल्ड? मैसेज सिग्नल फ्रीक्वेंसी. ओके या सो एम ऑफ टी इज एम कॉस 2 पाई बाय एफ एम टी. एम इज एम्पलीट्यूड ऑफ द मैसेज सिग्नल, एफ एम इज द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ मैसेज सिग्नल. सो व्हाट हैपेंस नाउ? सो सिंगल टोन एम, हियर वी रिप्लेस एम ऑफ टी विथ व्हाट? दिस फंक्शन am cos 2 pi fm t, because it is having only one frequency component and that's why it is called singleton am. Okay, now replace. What happens? AC 1 plus ka m of t cos 2 pi fct 1 plus ka, what is m of t? Am cos 2 pi fm t, am cos 2 pi fm t cos 2 pi fct. Now here this term ka into am, this term ka into am is called as mu. What is mu is called? Modulation index. Typically it is from 0 to 1. Okay, so this is about single tone am, means whenever a message is happened to be a sinusoidal signal, typically we take it as a am cos 2 pi fmt, where am fm are frequency, amplitude and frequency of the message signal respectively. So ka into am is called mu. Mu is a modulation index, or sometimes also called as depth of modulation. It is also called as depth of modulation. Typically it is from 0 to 1. Okay, now this is the single tone am equation. That is a single tone AM equation. That is what AC into 1 plus mu cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. What is mu? It is called modulation index, which is KA into AM. Okay. Now, so here based on this, we take now finally let me write S of t, the single tone AM signal is AC 1 plus mu cos omega mt into cos omega ct. This is a single tone AM signal. Okay, what is omega, what is fm here? It is a message signal frequency. What is fc? Carrier frequency. What is ac? Carrier amplitude. What was am? Message signal amplitude. I hope these are very simple to remember here. So as I told you, typically mu is between 0 and 1, but sometimes it is more than 1 also. This is a very reasonable value for mu. It should be always between 0 to 1, but it can be more than 1 also. We will see what happens if it is more than 1. Okay, now what is mu equal to? Ka into am. What is ka? I told you it is amplitude sensitivity. What is am? It is amplitude of the message signal. Here mu is constant generally. Okay, then what about units of ka? Units of ka is what now? Tell me the answer. Mu is constant, that equal to ka into am. What about units of ka? Units of am is what? Volt. Obviously units of ka would be volt inverse or 1 by volt. Is it okay? Right? Yeah. Here one more important thing. Here, so here suppose what is m of t in single tone AM signal? AM cos 2 pi FM T. What is carrier? Anyway, carrier is always C of T that equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT. Both are sinusoidal signals, both are cos terms, cos waveforms. Okay. Now, how to identify which is message, which is carrier? Both are cos functions only. So, how do you identify them? It is very simple. Okay. Identification is very, very simple. So, the carrier frequency should be much, much more than message frequency. Okay. So, which is carrier, which is message means obviously the sign, the cos function which is having more frequency is said to be carrier. Okay. Now, anyway, so M of T is a message signal. It is sometimes also called as what signal? Baseband signal. All message signals are usually baseband signals. Now, so the frequency of the carrier should be much, much more than the frequency of message signal. Okay. This is what I want to say. Very, very important. Next. Yeah. So this is one example. Here they're saying mu equal to 1 by 2. Here, message signal chosen to be a pure sinusoidal term, M of T is given to us, cos 2 pi FM T, and FM is 1 by 2 hertz, FC equal 10 hertz. Find the modulated signal or carrier. Can you find out? Just they're asking what is S of T. They're simply asking what is S of T equation. Correct? So what is S of T? What they're saying is here message signal chosen to be a pure sinusoidal signal M of T. It is single tone AM. They're referring to single tone AM. So what is the single tone AM equation? S of T equal to KC into 1 plus mu cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. You substitute everything. Everything is given to you, right? What is AC? So everything is given to you, just substitute. So this is the your AM signal equation. AC into, this is not given to you, keep as it is. 1 plus what is mu? 1 by 2. 1 plus mu cos 2 pi FMT. 2 pi FM. What is FM? 1 by 2. 2 to cancels. Pi T cos 2 pi FCT. FC is 10. 2 into 10, 20 pi T. Okay. So here, so 10 hertz is the frequency of the carrier. 1 by 2 hertz is the frequency of message signal. And mu equal to 1 by 2. This is the AM signal equation. Okay. Now, so now let us proceed. So far so good. Any doubts?
Sir, is there any reason for considering new value in between 0 and 1?
Yeah, there is a reason. We'll discuss later. So I'm coming to that only.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Right. Now, here, so we are taking three cases. Okay. What are the three cases? We are referring to value of mu. If mu is less than 1, case 1. Okay. Next. So there is another case where mu equal to 1. Third case is when mu is more than 1. Okay, we'll see these three cases depending upon the value of mu. what is the significance of mu? So here case 1, that is mu is less than 1. This is a case of where mu is less than 1, because here mu equal to how much? 1 by 2. Okay, now so here, so this is a message signal, this is the carrier. So what a difference you can observe? The carrier frequency is much much more than message frequency, correct? Okay, so here the carrier signal is very closely spaced, here it is somewhat largely spaced. So that's why I can say that this signal is having more frequency than this signal. So that's why it's called carrier, it is called message signal. Okay, now so this is the waveform of AM signal when mu is less than 1. Can you see it? So this is the AM signal waveform. So if you draw this, you will get like this only. Okay, now so let me draw here for understanding. How does AM waveform look like? So first of all, so let us take AM waveform. So it is something like this. So in between you get some signals like this. This is the AM waveform when mu is less than 1. Okay, so here when mu is less than 1, in the previous example, what was the amplitude of the carrier? What was that? It was this term. So this is the amplitude of the carrier after modulation, S of t. Okay, so what was that? AC into 1 plus 1 by 2 cos pi t. Okay, so then what happens? So let me write the amplitude of this carrier after modulation is AC, it could be any value, leave it, 1 plus 0.5 into cos pi t. Correct? Now, so what is the maximum value of cos pi t? Maximum minimum of cos pi t?
One maximum.
Minimum?
Minus 1.
Yeah. So it always between plus 1 to minus 1. So suppose if cos pi t is 1, what is the amplitude? AC into 1 plus 0.5. Correct. If cos pi t is minus 1, what happens? If it is minus 1, 1 minus 0.5. 0.5.
AC by 2.
AC by 2. Here this is 3 AC by 2. This is AC by 2. Isn't it? Yes or not? Okay.
Yes.
Here also you can observe clearly in the waveform. So here I am taking the positive side. Here this is the maximum amplitude. This is typically 3 AC by 2. What is minimum amplitude? This is the minimum amplitude. That is AC by 2. This is 3 AC by 2. Okay, so you can draw this waveform, no problem. To draw this waveform, it is looking like this. Okay, so here this is the typical waveform of AM when mu is less than 1. Okay, now so we take one more important concept, that is called एन वाला पाप है सिग्नल. व्हाट इज दैट? एन वाला पाप है सिग्नल. ओके, व्हाट इज एनवेलप? इफ यू जॉइन द पीक्स ऑफ एनी सिग्नल, इफ यू जस्ट जॉइन द पीक्स ऑफ एनी सिग्नल यू गेट ए कर्व. दैट कर्व इज कॉल्ड एनवेलप. एनवेलप इज अ कर्व ट्रेसिंग द सिग्नल पीक्स. और इफ यू ट्रेस द पीक्स ऑफ ए सिग्नल यू गेट ए कर्व. दैट इज कॉल्ड एनवेलप. सो प्लीज मेक ए नोट ऑफ दिस. ओके, एनवेलप मीन्स इफ यू जॉइन द पीक्स ऑफ एनी सिग्नल और इफ यू ट्रेस द पीक्स ऑफ एनी सिग्नल यू गेट ए कर्व, सम कर्व. दैट कर्व इज कॉल्ड एनवेलप. ओके, नाउ इन एएम एनवेलप प्लेस एन इंपॉर्टेंट रोल. ओके, सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई एम टेकिंग एक्स ऑफ टी इक्वल टू कॉस 10 पाई टी. ओके, सो यू टेक द सिग्नल. सो दिस इज सिग्नल. यू जस्ट जॉइन द पीक्स जस्ट लाइक दिस. इफ यू जॉइन द पीक्स व्हाट डू यू गेट? यू गेट अ कॉन्स्टेंट कर्व. दैट इज एनवेलप ऑफ यूर एक्स ऑफ टी. ओके, और इन अदरवाइज एनवेलप मीन्स मॉड ऑफ द सिग्नल. ओके, वॉट इज मॉड ऑफ दिस कॉस पाई टी? कॉस 10 पाई टी
वन
वन. दैट इज एनवेलप. दिस इज वन. Okay, anyway, so this is not required. Okay, so this is envelope. Okay, now here, so for every signal, if you take mod, you get a curve. That is called envelope. Okay, now, so here envelope is very, very important. Okay, so what is envelope? If you join the peaks of a signal or if you trace the peaks of a signal, you get a curve. That is called envelope. Okay, now we have a devices to catch the envelope of a signal or to extract the envelope of a signal. Okay, so we have devices which will extract the envelope of a signal. Okay, so that is envelope. Okay, right. Now what is the envelope of your AM signal? What is that? You just go back and just join the peaks. Okay. So this was your AM signal. It was something like this, correct? You just join the peaks like this. You're getting something like this. Correct? Okay. Otherwise, let us go to this waveform. You just take this and join them, something like this. Correct? So now how does it look like? This is your envelope. See, we are referring to which case? Please remember, when mu is less than 1. Okay, so we are referring to when mu is less than 1. Correct? So this is the envelope of your signal. Is it okay? So actually, what is the envelope of your signal now? In this example, what was the signal first of all? S of t, it was AC into 1 plus 0.5, I am writing, cos pi t into cos 20 pi t. So what is its envelope? envelope. Okay, which means envelope is simply AC into 1 plus 0.5 cos pi t. This is envelope. If you draw this curve, so let us forget about AC. Let us neglect this AC. What is the maximum value of this? Just now we told, you know, just now you told me.
3 AC
is 1. If AC is 1, how much?
3 by 2.
1.5. Minimum? 0.5. Yes or not?
Yes, sir.
You draw this curve. It looks like this. This is the envelope of your AM signal. Okay? So what happened actually? What happened? So if you remove, if you neglect this AC, just there is a DC shift. By how much? 1. And so here, what is the message signal in the example? Please go back to the example and tell me what is the message signal here. Cos 2 pi fm t, which means fm is 1 by 2, which means how much? What is m of t here? Cos pi t. Isn't it? M of t is cos pi t, c of t is cos 20 pi t. Now, here, what happened here in the envelope? Envelope is simply, so this is message signal now. What happened now? Envelope contains message signal. The only difference is it is shifted by 1 and it is attenuated by 1 by 2. Okay. So here, if you know envelope, if you get envelope, which means you got your message signal. Is it okay? Because envelope is nothing but message signal. Envelope resembles message signal. Because envelope follows message signal. And it also contains information about the message. Okay? So let us go back. How the envelope is looking like? Exactly your message signal, just like your message signal. Envelope follows message signal, which means if you got envelope from the carrier, from modulated carrier, which means you got your message signal back. Why it is so important? Why should we get our message signal back from the carrier? What it is called? Anyone?
Demodulation.
That is called demodulation. Okay. So, which means to demodulate a signal, we should get envelope. If you get envelope, you got your message signal back. Now, you can ask me, so how to overcome this problem? Very simple. This is a DC shift. Okay. How to remove DC component? Who will block the DC? Which component will block the DC component?
Capacitor.
You pass this through the capacitor. What will happen? This will be removed. Only thing is, you got 0.5 into cos pi t. Just you do amplification with a gain of 2. Then what do you get finally? Cos pi t. What is cos pi t? Your message signal. So that is the demodulation. Okay. So why I'm saying is, demodulation is much, much more complicated than modulation. You know why? Because while modulating, we are just keeping the message signal on the carrier, but in the channel, what happens? Noise will be added. Okay, so demodulation will be very, very crucial, very, very important, and difficult also. Why? Because you don't receive what is your transmitted. What do you receive? What you receive at the receiver? Your transmitted signal along with that Nice will be added. This is what you receive. Okay. So from this, you have to extract your message signal. Should get back your message signal. That is a difficult task. Anyway, so that is nothing but demodulation. Okay. Please remember, we are discussing everything if and only if mu is less than one. Okay. So if mu is less than one, the envelope is positive. Envelope is positive. You can see here. This envelope, it is always positive. That's why I am not talking about mod function. Is it okay? Actually, what should be envelope? Mod of this. But it is mod is not required because it is always positive. Just now you told me. Maximum is 3ac by 2, minimum is ac by 2. It never goes to negative. So that's why mod is not required. I'm removing this mod. Is it okay? So now, so this is about case one. Any doubts till now? If it is okay, we'll go further. Now, so I will ask you, if mu equal to one, what happens? Chalo, do it. If mu equal to 1, what happens? Case 3. You do it on your own, make it fast. Mu equal to 1, draw the waveform, draw the envelope. Draw on in your notes, make it fast. Don't look at the PPTs. You draw on your own. I've explained for mu less than one, no? You draw for mu equal to one. What will happen? What will happen? So let us take an equation. S of t equal to AC into, don't take any FCFM. That is not required. 1 plus mu cos omega mt into cos omega ct. So AC also you can neglect for time being. It is a constant, no? So if mu equal to 1, what happens? What is S of t will be now? 1 plus cos omega mt into cos omega ct. So what is the amplitude of the signal? Okay, so what is the maximum amplitude would be? What is the maximum value of cos omega mt? 1, 1 plus 1, 2. Minimum?
Zero.
Minus one.
0. Minimum 0, that's it, right? So it is always positive. I mean, it's always non-negative at least. If you take mod also, it remains same. It is not negative. So what is envelope? Envelope is
Positive
nothing
envelope.
but positive envelope. 1 plus cos omega mt. Draw this waveform. How it look like? It is just shifted by 1. Cos waveform is shifted by 1. How it look like? This is 2, this is 0, this is shift, this is envelope, E of t. So now here also, if you got the envelope, you got the message signal. Why? If you got the envelope, which is 1 plus cos omega mt, you just remove this component, you are getting your message signal back. Okay? Yeah. So let us see this. This AM waveform would be. What is happening? It is just touching the axis. This is the envelope. So here m of t is cos pi t, c of t is cos 20 pi t, mu equal to, I am taking 1, let us take. Then what happens? 1 plus cos pi t into cos 20 pi t. So obviously this is envelope. It is always positive. It could be 0, it could be 2, between 0 and 2. So this is the envelope. What has happened here? So just your message signal is shifted by 1. This is a DC shift 1. Okay, so envelope is positive. Okay, now when mu is more than 1, what happens? Case 2. It is called over modulation. What it is called? Over modulation. Okay, what happens if mu is more than 1? What happens? So let us take mu equal to 1.5. So let me make fastly. Okay, s of t equal to, I am not writing AC, 1 plus 1.5 cos omega mt into cos omega ct. What is the maximum amplitude of this s of t? How much is the maximum? 1 plus 1.5 means 2.5. 2.5, correct? Minimum? Minimum?
Minus 0.5.
Minus 0.5 means your amplitude is negative. For the first time, you are getting negative amplitude. Is it okay? So, here we should take mod. Because in the last two cases, the amplitude was positive. It was non-negative at least. So there mod was not required. Here you should take mod. Okay. So let us see what happens. Now, this is how your waveform look like. This is how your waveform look like. What's happening here? This is amplitude actually. It is something like this, and it is going negative also. Okay. In the third case, the amplitude was just touching the zero. Correct? Here it was like this, like this, like this, just touching the zero. But in this case, it is going negative. It's going like this. In the case one, it was always above the zero axis. It was always about zero axis. Okay. So when mu is more than one, so the amplitude goes to negative. Okay. Then, so envelope is nothing but mod of the amplitude. So if take, what happens? This is the envelope. Okay. So is it okay all of you? First of all, is here, what is envelope actually? Mod of?
X of actually, t.
Mod of x of t, but here what do you get? 1 plus 1.5 cos omega mt. You draw this first. How it look like? Maximum is 2.5, right? Minimum is 0.5. It would be like this. So please bear with my drawing skills. This is something like 1 plus 1.5 cos omega mt. If you take mod, what would happen? This negative becomes positive, which means this is envelope. So envelope is not proportional to m of t. It is not m of t. In fact, it is what? something like proportional to what? Mod of m of t. Is it okay? Envelope is not proportional m of t. In the previous cases, this is proportional to m of t. Proportionality means there is a shift, there is attenuation. Okay, so it is also proportional to m of t. But in whenever mu is more than one, envelope is proportional to mod of m of t. So it is called a distortion. It is called envelope distortion. Because envelope doesn't follow Mach signal, which means envelope does not contain any information about Mach signal. That is called distortion. That is called envelope distortion. Okay, so that's why always mu, either mu should be less than one or at least it should be equal to one, but it should never be more than one. So simply I can say it is always should be between what values? 0 and 1. If mu is more than 1, we get an envelope distortion. What is the problem of envelope distortion? What is the problem? What do you think of problem?
You cannot get the correct message.
Yeah, using envelope you cannot get the correct message signal. Means using envelope you cannot demodulate. Using envelope you cannot demodulate. Okay, yeah, so that is about mu. So typically mu should be between 0 and 1 for faithful reproduction at the receiver side. Is it okay all of you? When mu is more than 1, envelope does not follow Mach signal. It is proportional to mod of Mach signal. Okay. Now, so here this is about today's class. I think we should stop it now. Okay. Thank you.